Welcome to a lesson on perimeter. In this lesson, we will determine the perimeter of various polygons. Perimeter is a one-dimensional measurement that represents the distance around a closed geometric figure or shape. To find the perimeter, we add the lengths of each side of the shape. If there are units, we include units in the final result. Units will always be of singular dimension, for example, feet, inches, yards, centimeters, and so on. Perimeter is never in square units or cubic units. For the first example, we're asked to determine the perimeter of the given rectangle. Let's begin by labeling the lengths of all four sides. In a rectangle, opposite sides have the same length, and therefore the length of this side is 8 centimeters, the same length as the opposite side. The length of this side is 3 centimeters, the same length as the opposite side. Now that we have the lengths of all four sides, we determine the perimeter by adding these four lengths. So the perimeter is equal to, let's start with this side here. So 8 centimeters, going around clockwise, we have plus 3 centimeters, plus 8 centimeters, plus 3 centimeters. Well, because 8 plus 3 plus 8 plus 3 equals 22, the perimeter is equal to 22 centimeters. Notice for this example, I did leave the units on each length just to emphasize their perimeter is in centimeters. But often we'll leave the units off when determining the sum and then put the units in the final answer. Now some polygons do have formulas that can be used to determine their perimeter. In fact, you may have discovered one in an earlier activity. Two common formulas given to determine the perimeter of a rectangle are shown below, where P is the perimeter and one formula is P equals 2L plus 2W, where L is the length and W is the width of the rectangle. An equivalent formula is P equals 2B plus 2H, where B is the base and H is the height of the rectangle. So for this example, let's also find the perimeter using a formula. Let's use the formula P equals 2L plus 2W. This formula should make sense because notice how to determine the perimeter, we summed 2/8 and summed 2/3. Typically, L is the length of the longer side of the rectangle, but it really doesn't matter. So let's let L equal 8 centimeters and W equal 3 centimeters. So we'd have P equals 2 times 8 centimeters plus 2 times 3 centimeters. Simplifying, we have P equals 2 times 8 centimeters is 16 centimeters plus 2 times 3 centimeters is 6 centimeters. Of course, we get the same perimeter of 22 centimeters. Let's look at some more examples. For the remaining examples, we'll leave the units off until we determine the actual perimeter. Because the polygon has so many sides here, let's mark where we're going to start. So we'll start with this length here of 5 inches and work our way clockwise. So the perimeter is equal to 5 plus 3 plus 6 plus 2 plus 3 plus 3. So 5 plus 3 is 8, plus 6 is 14, plus 2 is 16, plus 3 is 19, plus 3 is 22. So the perimeter is 22 inches. For C, notice how we are not given the lengths of all the sides, so we need to begin by determining the length of this side and the length of this side. To determine the length of this side here, we can use the length of this side, which is 5 meters, the length of this side, which is 1 meter. This length here must be 5 meters minus 1 meter, which equals 4 meters. And now to determine the length of this side, we can use this length of 7 meters and this length of 3 meters. The length of this side must equal 7 meters minus 3 meters, which equals 4 meters. Now that we have the lengths of all the sides, we can determine the perimeter. The perimeter is equal to, let's go ahead and start with this side here, and again work our way around the polygon clockwise. So we have 7 plus 1 plus 4 plus 4 plus 3 plus 5 meters. 7 plus 1 plus 4 plus 4 equals 16, plus 3 plus 5 is equal to 24. Their perimeter is 24 meters. Let's look at one more example. Joseph does not own a car, so must ride the bus or walk everywhere he goes. On Mondays, he must get to school, to work, and back home again. His route is pictured below. How many miles does Joseph travel on Mondays? Well, looking at the route, from home to school is 3 miles, and then from school to work is 6 miles, and then work to home is another 6 miles. To determine how far Joseph travels on Mondays, we can determine the perimeter of this triangle. The perimeter is equal to 3 miles plus 6 miles plus 6 miles. Well, 3 plus 6 plus 6 is equal to 15. The perimeter is equal to 15 miles. So now we know Joseph travels 15 miles on Mondays. I hope you found this helpful.